It was an old one of those German gym things, Turner's Gym, and it had a ballroom essentially, a giant stage, and he did shows there from, like I said, like fall of '85 through fall of '87.
You probably ended up playing some really cool spots that were non-traditional but still pretty neat. But I understand that neat is
looking back.
neat is subjective. I mean,
they were good for pictures.
But I want to play a song from this absolutely fantastic record. Tomorrow night is the album release show at Red Flag. Not only do you get Ultraman, but you get Petty Grievances, mm-hmm. fronted by the one and only Scott Randall, who we love from Fragile Porcelain Mice. Tickets are available day of show. They're available today as well. You can go to the Red Flag website, anywhere else specifically that they can go. Day of show, they can go to the venue, too.
They can go to the venue, yeah. Maximum Effort would be playing first, too.
So Maximum Effort, Petty Grievances, and Ultraman. The album is called Dead End Thoughts Under a Crawling Sky. This track is called Forget to Remember. Ultraman live in the Point Studio. Forget to Remember from Ultraman, their new album, Dead End Thoughts, Under a Crawling Sky. Now, it is on all the streamers and stuff today, right?
Oh, yeah.
But then tomorrow, the full-on record release.
That's the show. That's actually the album releases today, the 16th. Today's okay. The 16th, right? Yes. It comes out today.
Show is tomorrow. Oh, my God.
Girlfriend Records.
Seriously, I thought for a second that the show was tonight and that I had been saying that it was tomorrow the entire time.
Oh, no.
And I my feet just got cold. So that's... Ooh, that's a relief. When I was a kid, there were a group of skater kids that were in my neighborhood, and they were the most interesting lot of guys, because when I thought that they were going to be mean to me, they would be nice to me, and then when I thought that they were going to be nice to me, they'd kind of give me a little bit of trouble. But they would never, ever let anybody else on the bus, like, pick on me. So, like, it was just this kind of, like, crazy relationship. But I remember their Vision streetwear shirts, and I remember watching them skate and think that it was the coolest thing. And, like, this cool, like, sort of club of people. Would you kind of, and I don't think it's necessarily that way anymore because, you know, obviously things have changed a lot. But did you kind of view... your role as punks or whatever is like kind of in your own thing, like your own kind of club with like-minded folks. Was it that way?
Well, especially early mid-80s, it was definitely like that. Even like within the scene where there were people who didn't necessarily get along or like each other.
Yeah, yeah.
We all hung out together because we were such a small group. Like but if anyone from the outside messed with even somebody you didn't particularly care for, then it was on.
Yeah.
You know, they would have each other's backs. I mean, that's just how it was. And I mean, I still skate, so I still see the crowd of kids that skate. Even though skating's bigger, I think there's still people who look down, you know, like there's like, oh, you're just a skater or whatever.
Yeah.
You know, like the negative attitude about what a skater, what they think it is. But yeah, I hope that still exists.
Like, yeah.
Yeah, I think it does. I'm going to believe it does.
And maybe just obviously just different now than it was then. You know what I mean? Just as like sort of an outsider, like looking in, it's still though a very accepting community on pretty much all aspects.
Yeah, I'm from Illinois. So, and again, I was teasing a little earlier. So I used to come see these guys. I loved Ultraman. I bought the record before I think I'd ever seen a show in St. Louis. I found a record at Music Vision or something in Belleville. And the blue vinyl,
right.
I still have it, you know, and everything. And what was kind of cool to me back then, especially at Ultraman, is if you went to an Ultraman show, a lot of the scene, sort of the people you're talking about, the kind of group of people that would go, most of them were there. So guys like us who knew no one, I mean nobody, because back then there was no going across the river hardly for anything, we would come over and meet people.
Right.
So I met Tim, actually. He probably doesn't remember, but I met him at Hullabaloo. I recognized him, and I said, hey, aren't you an Ultraman? And he went, yeah. All right, then, I was correct. Great. That was Mark Hines, actually, who walked in. And yeah, we were like, hey.
Yeah, I confirmed that question.
You sure did. But I met Rob. I met Rob when you guys played with Fugazi.
Oh,
and it was at 1227, and I had a Snake Ranch shirt on.
Okay.
And he said, I'm playing with Snake Ranch. I said, I know that. That's why I'm introducing myself to you, because I love Snake Ranch also. So, and me and Rob, who was the guitar player in Ultraman at the time, have been very good friends. We're both movie freaks, as your wife is as well.
Yeah, yeah.
But we're both movie freaks, and I don't think we've talked much about music ever in our life.
That's so crazy.
Playing it, because we played it together also in bands. And, yeah, so...
So there has been a lot of different people in Ultraman over the course of the year. So Tim, how does a band kind of remain what it is when you've got, not necessarily, I don't want to say revolving because I don't mean it that way, but when you do have...
It was a revolving door.
But when you have people coming in and coming out, like, right. How do you maintain what Ultraman is? Is that because of you?
Well, I wouldn't say that. I'll let someone else say it.
Right.
Well, I would never say that. Part of it's luck. Like, got really lucky to have access to people that wanted to play with us that were really good. I mean, almost from the beginning, like, the original lineup really only lasted 2 years. And then from that point on, it was just almost a yearly change of the second guitarist, changed drummers after 2 years. He stayed with us till the first end. And and then after that, just been lucky to find people that are willing to do it and really, really good. And that's part of it, too, is when I decided to do this again after all the reunions in the 90s, decided in 99 to do it again, like full-time-ish, I had to make sure that it was going to be with people that I knew would be able to also understand the band to begin with. That's why, mm-hmm, it's great with Tim. Like, mm-hmm, he knew the band, as an audience member.
Right.
Same thing with Bob Fancher. He's exactly 10 years younger than me. So, but I won't say how old I am. So I won't have to, because he doesn't want, I don't think he was even how old he is.
And his birthday is on Sunday. Boy, we just told everybody that, didn't we?
Yeah. So they knew the band.
Yeah.
So that helps. If this is just some like random person, hired gun, like they wouldn't get it. And so me and Bob, before I did it, Bob sort of, it pushed me to doing it, but he encouraged me to do it because I was like on the fence. Mm-hmm. I was like, I don't know if this is something I should do or not. I decided I kind of wanted to.
Mm-hmm.
He was like, you should do it. And we had several conversations, and he understood it. Like, he understood, like, the concepts of the band and the foundation of the of what the sound is and what it's about, I guess, is the only easiest way to put it. And when I figured out that, and I was like, okay, let's do this. And he's actually, besides myself, he's the longest term member of the band. He's been, so he's 25 years in.
Wow, that's amazing. Yeah. So tomorrow night, Red Flag, Ultraman record release show, new album, Dead in Thoughts Under a Crawling Sky, it will be available for purchase. You've got openers tomorrow night in Maximum Effort and Petty Grievances. Let's do this. Let's play another song from the record. Let's also play a Petty Grievances song, and then we'll come back and do a little bit more chit-chatting with the gentleman from Ultraman. Again, record release show tomorrow night at Red Flag. a shame. It's a shame to me that Scott Randall's voice is not unique. You know what I mean? It sounds like everybody else. Like, that guy, when I hear him singing for anyone, I know exactly who it is a half a second after it starts, and I know that I'm going to love it, and I know at some point it's going to get weird. You know what I mean? Scott is just one of those best dudes, and he is fronting Petty Grievances. That was their song, Swampy, and they will be at the show tomorrow night, opening for Ultraman, along with Maximum Effort. What is also very funny is that Scott, I believe, tried to send me a song to play at least two times. The link was incorrect both times, so I had to go do a little digging to find that particular Petty Grievances song, which I thought was very funny.
He's not an engineer. It's okay.
Yeah. Guys, real quick here, and this, you know, I was thinking about this at the very beginning, but can you just kind of maybe talk about some of the great, legendary, insanely crazy great bands that you had played with over the years? Because I assume that that list is long and super distinguished.
It's long even with me being in a band, but with Tone before that.
Because I think I remember the first time that I went to the Silver Ballroom, and I saw all of these, like, old show flyers, right. And it's like friggin' Ultraman playing with goddamn everybody. Like, it was legitimately, I want to say that I saw maybe a Descendants one. Would that be?
Yeah, that was Turner's.
Okay, you mentioned Fugazi already.
Yeah.
Who else? Come on.
The Exploited. They put me on the spot.
Yeah, I know.
We did Dead Kennedys. That was a later version of that.
It was 6 years ago.
Is there one or something that you remember being like, oh my God, these guys were so amazingly awesome?
Mine's 7 Seconds, because I love 7 Seconds.
Well, yeah, I love 7 Seconds. We played with them many times. Mm-hmm. The one band that we played with a few times that is, I'm an egomaniac, I'll just go ahead and admit that. Because there's confidence in the band. Like, I always felt like when we played with a band, we were at least as good as them.
Absolutely.
I never felt like, oh, they blew us away, except Rest in FU from Canada. Like,
okay.
We played with those guys. I was like, okay, I don't even know why we bothered.
That's something, man.
Yeah. They were amazing. Where do I even start?
I mean, it's just a litany of the who's who of punk bands over the last 20 years.
They started, when they put those flyers on the bar, I'm friends with Steve. I was in a band with Steve. I was like, well, good luck finding a flyer that doesn't have our name on it. And that was because of the guy I mentioned earlier, John Green.
Right.
We would sometimes play 2 or 3 times a week, because I would just call him and say, what shows do you have coming up the next few months? We want this one, this one, this one, and this one. And that's how we got on the shows.
But it's not like you just got put on those shows just because you called. You got put on those shows because you were a badass band and you called.
And drew people.
Right.
Yeah, drew people. That helps.
Yeah.
So two things would happen. Bands we would play with would go and see other bands that were on their way to St. Louis, and word had spread to ask for us to open. So that happened too. So we got on a lot of shows that way.
Absolutely. All right, guys, listen, here's the thing. I only have so much time, but I feel as though that we could talk about this, like, for hours. So you got to come back at some point or the other when you've got something. I would love for you to come back. The album from Ultraman, it's out today, but the release record show is tomorrow night at Red Flag. It's called Dead End Thoughts Under a Crawling Sky. It is, if you like punk rock, you are absolutely going to dig this record. It sounds fantastic. But Jay Robbins from Jawbreaker?
Jawbox. Government Issue in particular. That's where we met him, from Government Issue.
Did he produce the whole record or just a few songs on it?
He mixed it.
Okay.
Usually our drummer recorded it, and Jay Robbins mixed it.
Man.
Yeah.
Man. You guys are impressive. And this was a lot of fun. And this record is freaking great. Go to Red Flag tomorrow night. See this Ultraman record release show. And please, I hope to have you guys come back in.
Thank you.
Excellent. All right. Excellent. Ultraman wrapping up this segment here with the guys in studio. The song is called Doubt on 105.7 The Point.